Harry Truman once said, if you can't stand the heat, get out of the kitchen.
I thought you loved Mom's clam chowder.
Oh.
Don't confuse it with the Tupperware with the blue top, as it contains expressed breast milk.
Oh, dear.
Fortunately, the kitchen wasn't too hot for Mrs. Cavallaro.
Mmm, this is great.
This is nothing like Mom's.
Dad had his love life on the back burner.
A woman who is interested in you is always going to laugh too loudly at your jokes.
Robbie went from a simmer to a boil.
Okay, well, how much are we talking about?
$4,000.
Just put it all on tonight's hockey game.
You won.
No way.
And I was just trying to keep from getting burned.
Dr. Marcus, he vetoed you.
Why are you doing this to me?
I let you do one operation and you've taken over my office.
I should really get going. I like to get a good night's rest before a surgery.
What's going on?
Not to worry, dear. I've got to the best surgeon in Providence.
For what?
Your heart operation.
My heart is fine.
Au contraire, you're in acute emotional denial, particularly over a hunky doctor. Mush, mush.
Hildy, what are you doing here?
She was kind enough to enlist her brilliant young stud muffin nephew to perform your operation.
David, it's time.
What seems to be the problem?
It's her heart. Poor thing's completely out of touch with her feelings.
Yes, I can see why. Her heart's not in the right place.
You mean she doesn't have one?
It's more complicated than that. She has an extremely rare condition where the organ becomes detached from the body.
Detached? Where could it be?
Here, on her sleeve.
Oh, is there any hope?
If Sid can admit to the strong feeling she's experiencing, well, I think we can save her.
Sid, darling. There's no other choice. You're just going to have to tell Dr. Marcus how you feel about him.
I can't.
Unless you open up, no matter how mortifying, there's nothing I can do.
Do it, Sid. Tell him how you fell head over heels the first time you laid eyes on him.
Oh, couldn't I just say it was a mild infatuation?
I'm losing her.
Say something, Sid. Say anything.
Oh, no. No, I can't.
Come on.
I wish I could, but I can't. I can't.
There's nothing else I can do.
Providence parent, the cost of raising a child in America is roughly 200 grand. Factor in 5% annual inflation and you're at 340. And that's without college. She's a first child, so we can't have hand-me-downs. You take a look at Hannah and you figure her hair accessories.
Okay, Joanie, I gotcha. Isn't Richie helping?
Even if he pays half, I'm still chasing a huge number here.
If you need some money, I'd be happy to help you.
Aw, Sid, thanks. But I don't want to be in debt to a member of my family, you know? Worst comes to worst, I'll just declare bankruptcy.
Ugh, forget it. I've done the research. Your credit line goes right down the toilet.
So I won't open a computer company. It's better than selling myself on the street, maybe.
So, Robbie, what's with all the stuff?
Moving into the attic. Figured it's my shot at economic stability. About 6 months, I'll have enough money to get a nice place with Danny.
Oh, my God. Is this genuine maturity?
Yeah. And, of course, if the relationship goes south, I can always throw the cash into this oil deal that I've had my eye on.
Oil deal. I like the sound of that.
Well, it's highly speculative, sis. But if it's fast cash you're after, make me some more of your clam chowder.
What do you mean?
$100 in it for you if you can whip up a batch by the weekend.
Oh, you didn't like it that much, did you?
Well, let's just say that it has some magical qualities.
Dad did say it alleviated his constipation.
No, Joanie, it's an aphrodisiac.
Oh, come on!
Okay, after dinner, Danny and I went back to her place, and let's just say that it kept me up all night.
It's hard to believe it was the chowder. All right, for a fast 100.
Yeah?
Make it 200. Double the batch. Hey, doesn't hurt to try. Hildy. Hi.
Do we know each other?
We met outside in the park.
Oh, of course. Sydney, the doctor.
That's right. I wanted to thank you for what you did last week.
Well, you're more than welcome. What was it that I did?
Well, you convinced Dr. Marcus to let me perform the surgery on my friend.
Oh, that was nothing. Will you be staying for lunch?
No, I have to get back to my patients at the clinic.
Perhaps you can come back for tea on Tuesday. Go on, get going now.
Tuesday?
The circus is in town. They set up a lovely tent. You like elephants?
Yes, very much.
Well, then you're gonna love ours. We're the best circus in all of Providence, don't we, Hildy?
We do. David, do you know Dr. Hansen?
Yes, we've met.
I can see that now. You look very nice together. Maybe you could look after Dr. Hansen while I finish my rounds.
Promise. I'll see you Tuesday.
Right. What happens on Tuesday?
Tea.
Oh, right. See you then.
She can be very lucid at times, but at other times her imagination takes over.
Oh, she's a wonderful lady.
No question.
I should get back to the clinic.
It was nice running into you. I was going to call you anyway.
You were?
I wanted to apologize for the miscommunication of last week.
Oh, that's not necessary.
Well, I also wanted you to know that while I can't offer you full-time surgical privileges, you're welcome to bring something in on a case-by-case basis.
That's very nice of you.
It's the least I can do.
Oh, bye.
Bye.
Good morning. I'm Dr. Hansen.
Chelsea Town.
Hi, Chelsea. Why don't you have a seat? So you're here for chronic back pain.
It comes and goes. I'm a dancer, and every now and then I whip myself around that pole too fast and tweak it good.
So you're an exotic dancer?
Oh, trust me, nothing exotic about it.
I see you're taking baclofen for the pain. Well,
don't worry, Doc. I'm not a druggie or anything like that.
Oh, that's not what I was suggesting.
Well, my last doctor, when he found out I worked at the classy lady, he just assumed.
And take a breath. So you have no disc or nerve problems?
Can't say for sure. I just know sometimes it hurts so bad I have to sleep on the kitchen floor.
Take another breath. So did this first start when you matured physically?
How'd you know?
It's often a problem for full-figured women.
Oh, that's the least of it. I can't remember the last time a man looked me in the eyes. They just see one thing. Mm-hmm. Make that two, if you know what I mean.
I think I do, although I've never experienced it personally.
Consider yourself lucky.
How'd you get that scar?
Beer bottle. Wasn't meant for me, but I caught it.
Well, the ER doctor should have made sure you had plastic surgery.
That'd have been tough. We didn't have an ER in our part of Mississippi.
Well, if you ever get a day off, I'd be happy to fix it for you.
Are you a plastic surgeon?
Yes, it's my specialty.
Well, what do you know? I've been saving up for that breast reduction surgery to get out of the strip business.
Well, first things first. Here's your refill for baclofen. And I'd like to do a spinal x-ray just to make sure we don't have something more serious here.
Thanks, doctor.
I'll go get you a gown. I'll be right back.
Yeah, well, if we could just review the logic here, okay? You haven't been paid, so you are charging me a late fee. Now, what makes you think you are any more likely to get paid that when you can't even collect what I already owe you?
I got something for you.
Oh, I see. Okay, then you're an idiot.
You're an idiot.
Not now, Larry.
You're an idiot.
You okay, Joanie?
Just a little stressed.
Did you take a break?
Take a break.
Thank you both.
She's having kind of a tough day, Larry. Try not to ruffle her feathers, all right?
Look at those legs. Who's your daddy?
Sorry about Larry, Mrs. Blake. He was raised on a construction site.
Oh, please don't apologize, Dr. Hansen. Jim.
What can I do for you, Mrs. Blake?
Cynthia. Yes, well, I want you to take a look at Kobe. He has a breeding session in a couple of days, and I'm just not sure he's up to it.
Really? How do you mean?
Well, he's just always been so social, and lately he's withdrawn. I arranged a romantic evening for him and Rosie, and he spent it at the other end of the house watching TV. And when Rosie finally fell asleep, he came into my bedroom and sacked out.
Well,
Sounds like the two of you could use some counseling.
Oh, no, no, I think we'd prefer to work it out ourselves.
I was joking.
Oh, no. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, dear. Oh, yeah, like I'd be on the big couch and he'd be on the little couch. That's cute.
Well, perhaps I can keep Kobe here overnight and see what I can find.
Oh, that'd be great. Just let me know if he can go through with this breeding session next week, okay? You know, Kobe is a highly decorated show dog. Mm. And he's still very much in demand, aren't you, baby? Yes. Yes, we are.
Hey, Rob, how's it hanging?
Never been better, Vince. Drinks are on me.
Well, what's the occasion?
You helped me out of a serious jam, my friend.
No, you're the one that picked the winner.
Yeah.
So tell me, how's it feel? 4 G's in your fold? Living large now, huh?
Well, money was actually for my girlfriend. You know, help her pay tuition.
The brunette. She's a jock, right?
Yep. She plays basketball.
Well, you know, we should go out sometime. And double up with me and my girl.
Sure.
Just picked up the racing form. Got any hot greyhound picks?
I think that's gonna be it for me in gambling. You know, I'm just gonna walk away a winner.
Hey, you ever seen the dogs race?
No, haven't.
Oh, they're really graceful, Robbie. I'll tell you what. Pick 3 of these.
Now, I don't even have the money to lose right now, so.
You don't need any. I'm putting it down for you. Now, this is the $100 trifecta. Pick 3 in the order in which you think they'll finish. Come on.
Come on, Vincent, I don't want to lose your money, man.
Hey. You're on a hot streak. You do a good deed, this is what happens. Luck comes back to you, you know? Come on, pick.
Well, yeah. We got El Duque, Stilt, and Glide.
Oh, you could make a ton of money tonight.
All right.
Sid. Your spinal x-rays are here.
Oh. How do they look?
It's an awful lot of disc degeneration for a woman that young.
Well, she's an exotic dancer who's very full-figured.
All natural?
Can't get more natural. Do you recommend surgery?
It's only a matter of time. Such a high-risk operation, I'd advise her to find a new career.
Well, she wants to get out, and she's planning a breast reduction.
She better do something. She'll be using a cane by the time she's 30.
Yeah.
I gotta get going.
Okay,
I'll see you later.
Do you want anything before I go, Dr. Hansen?
Oh, no thanks, Patrice.
Night.
On second thought, Patrice,
yeah.
Can you pull Chelsea Towns' file?
Mm-hmm.
Excuse me.
Sorry, honey. Auditions are on Tuesdays. No exception.
I'm not here to audition.
Too bad. What can I do you for?
Looking for Chelsea Town.
Straight back. Oh, and if you change your mind, come back Tuesday.
Thank you.
I'm gonna do what normal people do in work.
That's a joke.
I don't even know why I'm talking to you about this. I told you I don't want to see you anymore, and I mean it.
Yeah. Well, you will be seeing me.
Mr. Hansen.
I can come back another time.
No, don't worry about Rick. Sit down. You know, I've been trying to break it off with him for the last month, and he's having a hard time with the message. What's up?
Your spinal x-rays came back. Unfortunately, they're not very encouraging. You have a disc problem that will ultimately require surgery.
That's not good news.
I've been thinking about what you said about getting a breast reduction.
Yeah?
Well, I'm trying to get my hospital privileges so I can resume work as a plastic surgeon. And basically, I need a patient.
But I'm not even close to having the money.
Well, I'd throw in my fee. You'd only be responsible for hospital expenses.
That is so generous of you.
Not really. You'd be helping me get my hospital privileges.
When can we do it?
It is major surgery, so I insist on a consultation before you make your final decision.
Okay. Great. Oh, Dr. Hansen, before you go, I need to tell you, I haven't been entirely honest about something.
What's that?
Chelsea's my stage name. My real name is Rebecca.
Okay, Rebecca. Call me.
Thank you.
Dr. Marcus.
Dr. Hansen. Didn't expect to see you again so soon.
Well, I didn't expect to be here again so soon, but after our conversation yesterday, I saw a patient who I think would make an interesting surgical candidate. I put together a presentation outlining her case.
What kind of surgery?
Breast reduction.
Cosmetic?
No, she has a degenerative disc problem. I can have the x-rays sent over if necessary.
Well, will the surgery alleviate her back problems?
Well, I can't say that for certain, but it should help. It's a complicated situation. We're talking about a person who needs a life change.
How's that?
She's from a poor rural background and works as an exotic dancer. She desperately wants to get out of that life, and I think that this surgery could act as a springboard for that.
It's really not my specialty, Doctor. I'll have to run it by my colleagues, but shouldn't be a problem.
Great.
So you can see here, Kobe's hips are starting to splay.
What do you think's causing that, Jim?
Well, what we see here is a deteriorating condition called old age.
Oh, Kobe's only 7 years. I wouldn't call that old. Sure, he's slowed down and he's put on some weight around the middle, but I think the extra pounds look good on him.
Growing old is no cause for alarm, Mrs. Blake.
Oh, Cynthia.
Cynthia, it's a perfectly natural part of the process, but we may have to change Kobe's diet and his routine a little.
Should I cancel the breeding session? I mean, I wouldn't want Kobe to pull a Nelson Rockefeller on us. Oh, perhaps we should have it here at the clinic, and that way you could be close by.
Well, if that would make you feel more comfortable.
That would make me feel more comfortable, yes. Of course, it is a crazy time right now. The mayor is sponsoring a Taste of Providence cooking contest, and as president of the garden club, I'm responsible for all of the centerpieces.
Oh.
You know, if you would like to see my work, I would love for you to be my... a guest.
Oh, that's very nice of you, but I think a cooking contest is the wrong place for me. But you know, it might be right for my daughter, Joanie. She just cooked the most amazing clam chowder the other night. Can anyone enter?
Any resident of Providence?
Joanie?
I'm not interested, Dad.
Well, somebody's got to win, and $5,000 will make it worth their while.
I'm sorry, did you say $5,000?
No, I don't think he sounds like such a great guy. He's a bookie.
Well, he's also a friend.
Why, because he wants a double date at the dog track? You don't know anything about this guy.
So, I didn't know anything about you when we met. You've quickly become my odds-on favorite.
Oh, my God. Is he your money man? Is that how you got my $4,000? Gambling?
Gambling? Me? Come on.
Robbie, my boy.
Vincent, hey, this is Danny.
Well, it's a pleasure to meet you, sweetheart.
Hi.
Your boyfriend is on a streak.
What are you talking about?
You picked the trifecta. Congratulations, man.
Excuse me, I'm gonna go freshen my drink.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There you go. Now, while you're hot, you wanna lay something on the dogs tonight?
No, this money is earmarked for a new futon.
Yeah. Different kind of nest egg, huh?
Yeah.
It'd be a shame to let this streak die. Your boy El Duque's running again tonight. I'm betting on him, thanks to you.
Well, I wish you luck. I'm gonna pass, and I think I gotta go.
I understand. Hey, Robbie. Go for the deluxe mattress. She's worth it.
Thanks.
Dr. Hansen.
Rebecca.
I'm sorry, I'm late. I just stopped to pick you up some goodies.
Oh, thank you. You grow these all yourself?
Well, I rent a half-acre plot down by the river, and I have a small greenhouse in my apartment.
I love cherry tomatoes.
Well, there's some gold nugget squash and my own favorite, Westport sweet macumber.
Oh, that's a turnip, right?
Listen to you. Most people confuse them with rutabagas.
You know, Rebecca, I'm really happy that you're here. For a minute there, I thought you might have gotten cold feet.
No way. I'm so excited, I can barely contain myself. Well, where do we start?
Well, let's see. First, I have a list of potential risks and side effects. I'd like you to take it home and read it very carefully.
Will do.
I pulled some photographs of some ex-patients. I thought it might give us an idea of what direction we'd like to move in. This woman here had even more severe back problems than you do. I guess you can see why.
You have to wonder why the Lord would do a thing like that.
Well, believe me, we all have our own imperfections. So, do any of these look like what you had in mind?
I think...
I think I'd like yours.
Mine?
In honor of the woman that's helping me reshape my life.
Okie dokie. Here we go. Good.
This better be worth 100.
Actually, 5 grand.
What do you mean?
I'm entering Mom's Chatter in the Taste of Providence cook-off.
There's something wrong.
What are you talking about?
It's not the same.
I use the same ingredients, the exact same cooking time. I did everything like last week.
But I didn't.
What do you mean?
Well, it was my job to add the milk, remember? Only, I didn't. I forgot.
But the chowder was still creamy. There was milk in it. Somebody must have... Mrs. Cavallaro. The blue top. She added the wrong container.
Don't blame her. She is blind, after all. What is that, anyway?
Breast milk.
Wow. I guess that gives a whole new meaning to Mom's clam chowder.
Oh, yuckity. Yuck, yuck, yuck.
So what's the problem? I mean, there's always more where that came from, right?
Not 2 quarts worth. Hey. What a surprise.
Sorry to drop in unannounced, but I wanted to talk to you in person.
Sure, have a seat. Something wrong?
This morning after you left, I ran your surgical candidate past a few of the senior plastics guys.
Mm-hmm.
One of them, Dr. Godden, stopped by about an hour ago. He feels strongly that it's inappropriate surgery.
Why?
In the absence of an acute medical emergency, it's purely cosmetic.
What about her back problems? Would he prefer I do a more serious and dangerous disc surgery?
Quite frankly, yes.
That's ludicrous.
I can't completely disagree with you, but I have to respect his point of view.
Right, but you have the final word.
Yes and no. If Dr. Godden feels strongly enough, he can appeal the decision to Dr. Koster.
And then you could intercede.
I made a promise to Dr. Koster that while he's recovering, he has nothing to worry about. That's a commitment I'm not willing to break.
What about my commitment to my patient?
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, too. For a minute there, I thought you were the kind of doctor who put your patient's welfare first.
I'm glad you're taking it so graciously.
I graciously have to explain to my patient why she can't have the surgery she was promised.
Well, I'm sorry, Dr. Hansen. Maybe you shouldn't have made those promises to begin with.
Who is it?
It's me, Rebecca.
Door's open, Dr. Hansen. Minute.
Hey, great herb garden.
It's been my hobby since I was a kid. You can take the girl off the farm, but you can't... Well, you know the rest.
Oh, my God, what happened?
Oh, Rick came around last night. I told him I was starting a new life, and he wasn't any part of it.
At least your eye's okay. Did you call the police?
It wouldn't do any good. It'd just make him madder. Best thing I could do is just stick to the game plan and move on. You want some tea?
Sure.
At least I won't be seeing him around the club anymore.
What do you mean?
I gave notice. Tonight's my last night.
You didn't tell me.
I figured, you know, why wait? When they get a load of the new improved me, they'll be showing me the door anyway. Is something wrong, Dr. Hansen?
Yeah, Rebecca, I ran into a snag at University Hospital.
A snag? Does that mean you won't be doing the operation?
No, I can apply at county, but it's gonna take some time.
How long?
I don't know.
I guess you're telling me I should probably hold on to my night job.
I feel awful about this.
Don't you dare. I'm gonna have that operation, and you're gonna do it. This is just a minor setback, and we'll both look at it that way.
Oh, soy milk is too watery. I don't know, Dad. There might not be a substitute for mother's milk.
No. Don't give up. Here we go. Human milk, water, lactose, fatty acids. Same as all the other milks. It's highest in cysteine content.
You said goat's milk had cysteine.
Not enough.
What about sheep's milk?
Not enough fatty acids.
Hey, Dad, you know anything about greyhounds?
They like to chase rabbits.
Maybe we could buy cysteine at a store.
Hey, you know, I think there's L-cysteine in that vitamin powder Sid gave me.
Well, let's
see. You think so?
Damn, he's right. What do you think, tablespoon?
Yeah. Tastes great.
Less filling.
Joanie, you're back in business.
Oh, great. Okay, Robbie, take this batch downstairs, put it in the fridge to cool.
Okay.
Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
It's Robbie.
Hey.
Hey, Vince, what's up?
I thought you might want to know, pal. The odds are 10-1 on your boy El Duque. Put up $4,000, you could forget the futon. You could have your own mattress store.
I think I'm gonna pass on this one.
Robbie, there's a guy at the door with a futon delivery.
Thanks. You know what, Vince? I'm gonna run, but
thanks for the call.
Okay, kid.
It's almost 9. What are you doing back here?
I figured it's Wednesday night and you're probably still here.
Paying bills. My favorite part of running a clinic. Got some pizza if you want a late dinner.
Nah, thanks. That went to hell. Why is it that women always eat when they're depressed?
If I remember correctly from my psych classes, it has something to do with our desire to punish ourselves.
And then so much of our self-image is wrapped up in our bodies.
I think that has something to do with our role in propagating the species. How are things with Chelsea?
Not good. Her ex-boyfriend abuses her. When he found out she quit the club, I think he was threatened.
And now you feel personally responsible because you tried to help.
Something like that.
Sid, you can always choose to mind your own business. Or you can finish what you started.
How long do you think it would take to get privileges at county?
That place is a zoo. A month or two at least.
Oh, this is so greasy. Must be so fattening.
Why do you think we're eating it?
Looks great.
Yeah, we'll get a hell of a lot better in our own place.
Someday.
Yeah, sure. When you're in the WNBA and I've opened Robbie's righteous ribs.
Good things take time.
And a little luck never hurts.
Hey, you promised me no more gambling.
Now, when did I promise this?
Well, you didn't exactly promise me yet, but I thought maybe tonight I could convince you.
Really? Well, exactly how are you planning on doing that?
Are you still feeling the effects of the chowder?
No.
What about now?
Nope, no, definitely not. Well, maybe just a little. Try that again. Don't stop. Hello?
Hey, I just put down $5,000 of my own. You win?
I don't know. You want to spend the next year in your old man's attic? Okay, no, I'm in.
Same as last time?
Yeah, whatever, sure.
Sid, it's time to go on.
I don't think I can go through with this, Mother.
Nonsense.
Sooner or later, you have to break through this proper feminine veneer.
Men want to see your energy, your passion, your tassels. How do I look?
Trust me, it's inspired.
You know, it really doesn't feel like me.
Hello, it's the fantasy you. Not the uptight physician, but the sexy vixen lurking inside. She's the one Dr. Marcus really wants to see.
You think?
I know. Come on, Dr. Hansen. It's time to make a house call.
Oh.
it.
Is that you? What are you doing here? Looking like that?
That's a really good question.
Well, Sid, if you think coming down here in that getup is going to influence this honorable group of physicians to change their mind about your operation, well, I'm afraid you've grossly miscalculated.
It's scandalous.
Outrageous.
Oh, take it off.
What? What? Oh, see, it wasn't my idea. My mother made me do it. Leaving now. Bye.
Sid, wake up. Wake up, you have a phone call.
Who is it?
A lady named Ruthie from The Classy Lady.
Hello? Yes, this is Dr. Hansen. What? When? Yeah, okay, calm down, I'll be right there.
What happened?
Oh, a patient of mine just got shot.
Oh my God.
Multiple gunshot wounds, lateral chest, 2 liters saline in, BP's crashing, down to 50
pounds. What happened?
Who are you?
I'm a doctor.
Rick showed up. I hadn't flown out, but he was waiting for her in the alley when she left. She had a gun for protection, but when he forced her into his car, it went off.
On my count, 1, 2, 3. 4 units O-neg, type and cross for 8, spin a crit.
Okay, just go with the officer.
Damn, decreased breath sounds on both sides. I need help. Have you ever done a chest tube?
Hundreds of times, I'm a surgeon.
Great, you take the right, I'll take the left.
Okay, gloves.
We're gonna put some tubes in your chest to help you breathe, okay? It'll be all right. It's a 16-gauge angio, no known allergies.
I'm losing a pulse.
Got it. Scalpel.
Tension pneumo, I need to dart the chest. 14-gauge.
Chest tube.
All right, that should help. 10 blade.
Still high, PO2 is...
D5 quarter normal.
Chest tube, 34 French.
D5 quarter.
Pulse is stronger.
Neck pains are coming down.
Yeah, I'm gonna need another pleurovac here.
Hook it up to suction.
Pulse ox is better, 92.
Get an ABG. Where's X-ray?
Well, CQ.
Okay, we're set here.
BP is coming up, 70 over 30.
Great, let's move her.
Here we go.
Coming through.
OI3 set up. CO2 still low.
All right, we'll take it from here.
All right.
Thanks, doctor.
Hansen, Sid Hansen.
Here we go, Rosie.
Thanks for the hand. I hope Kobe's up to this. Seemed a little lethargic this morning.
Sounds like Rosie's in the mood.
Well, she's not the problem.
Oh, he'll do fine. Some of the thrill may be gone, but whatever he lacks in enthusiasm, he can make up with experience.
Well, I brought his favorite quilt. I thought it might make the place a little less clinical. And then I brought some Johnny Mathis.
Johnny Mathis?
Yeah, well, it always works for me. Okay, Kobe, sweetheart, I brought you some trophies to remind you that you're a prize-winning show dog. So I want you to give Rosie the blue ribbon treatment. You got that? You understand me? You...
Ms. Blake,
may I?
I tell you what, Kobe, forget about the trophies and forget about the blue ribbons. Too much pressure. Just focus on today, all right? Just relax, do what comes naturally, go at your own pace, and have fun. That's right. Okay, and we'll be right upstairs.
Oh, okay, let's go. Go get her, buddy.
There we are. Can I get you a cup of coffee, Sid?
Oh, that would be so nice, Jim. So how are the kids?
Oh, they're doing just great, thank you. Robbie has this terrific new girlfriend.
Oh, well, that makes such a difference. You know what? I don't think I've ever seen the upstairs of your house.
Oh, sure. I could, I guess, arrange a tour while we wait.
Oh, that would be so sweet of you, Jim.
We could start with the living room. And I think we're done.
I gotta go, thanks. I I heard about what happened. I want to offer my apologies.
Great. Thanks.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, well, maybe I should have been a little more alert to the fact that something like this could have happened.
No, you were just trying to help. How is she?
No, she's not out of the woods yet.
Is there anything I can do?
I don't think so.
It's county deadline, too.
Oh, great. Sid Hansen. When? Yeah, I'll be right there. Thanks.
What's wrong?
She's got intercostal bleeding. They've got to go back in.
Who's doing the operation?
I don't know.
Can I offer my services?
Sure.
You can assist if you want.
I'd like that.
Good. Then let's get her moved to university.
Ladies and gentlemen, our first annual Taste of Providence cook-off has come down to these finalists you see standing before you. So without... Thank you. So now, the envelope, please. Third prize at $1,000.
Vince, what's up?
Goes to Miss Sylvia Carlson for her delicious Yankee pot roast.
You okay?
Second prize.
Great.
And $2,500 goes to Martha McWilliams for her outstanding albacore casserole. And the grand prize and $5,000 goes to our very own mayor, Buddy Cianci, for his mayor's own marinara.
Yes! Thank you. Thank you very much. I have a confession to make. Next to being elected mayor of Providence, my biggest ambition in life always was to win a cooking contest. So I thank you very much. I appreciate this. And of course, there's no better cooking contest than the one we're inaugurating in Providence today. Don't you all agree with that? I think so. And so we can continue our great tradition of culinary excellence here in Providence. I'm going to take this money and I'm going to donate it to establish a yearly scholarship fund at Johnson and Wales Culinary School, right here in Providence. Wow. Yes.
And the first recipient of that scholarship goes to Miss Joanie Hansen for her mother's clam chowder.
Cooking school?
Yeah! All right!
Nice work, Dr. Marcus.
You're pretty good hands yourself, Dr. Hansen.
So what kind of recovery time are we looking at?
I hate challenging the gods, but barring any unforeseen complication, she should be on her feet by the end of the week.
Thank you, Dr. Marcus.
Now that we've operated together, maybe you can call me David.
Thanks, David.
You're welcome, Dr. Hansen.
Exactly the operation I had in mind for you.
Me either. I still want to go through with it.
Well, let's just get you out of here first, and then we'll sit down and talk. Get some rest. I'll come back in the morning.
I don't know how I'll ever repay you.
I do. You get me a lifetime supply of those turnips.
Mm-hmm. How many is that?
One. Okay.
There you are.
Hildy.
I knew you were bound to turn up sooner or later.
Lately, I seem to be drawn to this place, don't I?
It's become part of your cosmic path. You've seen my nephew?
Yes. Actually, we performed an operation together earlier.
I overheard him talking to Dr. Garden last night.
Last night?
He told him he had no right to deny your patient a place in a hospital.
He said that?
And then he told him a lot of other things that I can't repeat.
Do you know where I can find David?
Of course. He'll be in the children's ward. Just follow the music.
Thanks, Hildy. Congratulations, Jody.
Here, here.
Thank you.
So you really going to cooking school?
No. It wasn't my first choice, but hey, why not?
You're like old times. I can drive you to school every morning.
Yeah, I'll cry, we'll be late, right, and I'll get mad.
Well, you said it yourself. There are no sure things.
I thought we had. Anyway, they're going to want their money by Thursday.
Yeah. To be honest with you, I kind of had a bad feeling about it, you know? There you go.
$100. Where's the rest of it?
Well, that's it.
No, Robbie, you bet your credit line. Same as last time, $4,000.
Vincent, I never said that.
Look, I asked you specifically. I'm sorry, Chief. Every streak comes to an end. Can I get a beer here, please? $100.
Support.
Hi.
Hi. You're very good.
Key is to throw a surprise animal in every now and then. Nothing wrong with pigs and cows, but an occasional platypus really adds pizzazz to the farm.
Mm. Dr. Marcus.
David.
David, I heard that you talked to Dr. Godden last night about letting me do the surgery.
I take it you ran into Hildy.
Why didn't you tell me?
I started to, but when I called the clinic this morning, Helen told me that Rebecca had been shot. And under the circumstances, it felt inappropriate.
Well, I hope you don't find it inappropriate that I say thank you.
No. Listen, I don't know about you, but I'm starving. Care to grab a bite to eat in the cafeteria?
I'd love to. What noise does a platypus make?
I'll show you. Oops. Spoke too soon. It's closed.
Oh, well, if you don't mind leftovers, you could come by my house and grab a bite.
Leftovers? You really know how to hook a guy.
My sister made a very special clam chowder last night.
Oh, what's so special about it?
If you can believe my brother Robbie, it actually,
What?
Well, maybe you should just see for yourself.
In a meeting.